aboard the Vselka this time around. Kola Peninsula, Russia, January 26, 2005, 23:29 hours. It's sort of funny how these missions take place on January 26 because that is also the Indian Republic Day, but I digress. Colonel Alexievich's men have taken control of the Vselka in her berth and are attempting to acquire the warheads from several SSN-20 Sturgeon nuclear missiles. The main computers on the bridge of the sub must be accessed to determine whether or not the warheads have been off-bolted. So basically, we need to confirm whether, you know, they actually have acquired any nukes or not. This might be a continuation of the Georgian attack on the US soil. Anyway, let's get this.
Fisher, Grim's daughter needs you to get inside the communication room. There's a central server inside you'll need to tap into.
Can I ask why?
As long as you don't expect an answer. Nature of the agency. Be good.
Yeah, that is pretty... I mean, that's a pretty well-made script right there. And I'm thinking they were trying to... They were planning on using it somewhere. They just didn't. But yeah, this first section is going to be a little... We're going to have to be a little sneaky for this first section at least. Let me just make a mission start save here. Okay, so basically the door we need open is that one, and that is currently closed. So we want that door to be open, and for that to be open, let me just go ahead and make another save here. We need to head into this little room so that there's a guy there who can unlock the door for us. Let's hope that he does not see me before I get around to, you know, hiding. Yeah, so that guy who's working on the projector, or maybe that guy who's on the computer, the one on the right, one of these guys actually goes and unlocks the door for us. Or so I hope. None of them are moving yet. My god. So, yeah, this part is tricky, because we need these guys to unlock the door, I don't know why. We can use the computers, but it isn't really doing much for us. This guy sort of just does his own thing at his own time. And I do believe he takes quite a lot of time to get back as well. I mean, I guess I could try following him into, you know, wherever he's going. In an attempt to sort of... I can hear him returning though. See if he opens the lock or not. But I don't know why they made this section the way they did, because it would have been completely fine. I don't know why they made the section the way they did, because it would have been completely fine even otherwise. So I lowered my speed. Let's hope he does not come back this way. Because if he does, it's gonna be, you know, pretty bad. Good thing there are plenty of shadows here. My god, what more could a man ask for? There's something over there, I don't know what it is, but there's certainly something over there. And the first time around that I was trying to sneak through the section, it was pretty damn difficult, to be honest. Let me go ahead and make a quick save here. I bumped into the guy that I was trying to knock out. Yeah, that's good. Now let me just pick you up and move you into the shadows so that nobody will know where you are. I'm guessing this is a good enough spot. If it isn't, nothing can be done about it. Now, I always find it to be sort of a chore how you need to move everybody into the shadows, or things won't work in your favor. There are other people below us patrolling, you know, doing the rounds as well, but I can't seem to see any thus far. Maybe the game just hasn't loaded them in yet. At any rate, we go here next. We don't go down as far as I recall. I think we need to keep, oh yeah, we need to keep, definitely keep moving straight. Come here. Here, giddy.
I've got the corpse here.
And that's that. Let's just switch the lights off so that these guys are in the shadows. The sounds in this game, the spatial part isn't exactly the best. Who saw me? How did you see me? Is my question. How did you hear me? I did not make a noise. How did you see me? I did not, again, to reiterate, make a noise. Now, I saw Splinter 01 sneak through this section flawlessly, but I don't know how he did it. And I can see that the lighting system isn't exactly working that efficiently in this area. I think the body's down. There's another guy down there that we need to take care of, metaphorically speaking. Maybe not gonna take care of him, we're just gonna dispose of him. Might as well turn the light off here. And yeah, the game becomes far easier when you're trying to, when you can just take people out.
Who's out there?
Anybody else that wants a piece of me? No, of course not. I could just switch the object. Oh, sorry, switch the light off in here, can't I? It's sort of strange how these guys get to know about my presence, you know, like that. But at any rate, let me make another save because the game is going surprisingly smooth sailing. The level is going surprisingly smooth sailing as well. I think we have to go upstairs next. Oh no. We go upstairs, yes. Or not, I forgot. Oh yeah, there's nothing upstairs. We go straight. Wasn't there somebody down there patrolling? Even if we can't see him now, there he comes about. There's somebody who, you know, starts patrolling that area. And I need to move slowly because everything is made of metal. I can see a medkit on the floor. That's gonna be mine. See, thus far. Now, I can't imagine playing through one of these missions minus the ability to save.
Somebody's been there.
That was some snappy aim. I did not know I had such good aim in me. I'll be honest with you. I can't take these lights out. Of course I can't. Now what to do with the bodies? Ah, luckily I've got some shadows here. I've got a lot of shadow here. Let's just make a dog pile of corpses. When I shocked this guy, I did not expect it to set off like a chain reaction. Can I use the computer? Let's go ahead and read the data 6 in a minute. Actually, this is more convenient. Let's stuff them in one of the cabins. What the fuck just happened? Oh yeah, I think there's like one of the guards. He starts patrolling downstairs. Look at Sam Fisher. Just look at this guy. Nobody suspects a thing. Nobody knows. Quick save. And Silver's Armoury door code is 20387. Torpedo tube hat sequence can be automated from the launch computers to make a sub-aquatic extraction. So basically a torpedo extraction, like a manual torpedo extraction, I think. Anyway, a data stick. Jaro, regardless of the uniforms, these guys are not Russian soldiers. I'm going for help. I'm going to try a sub-aquatic exit from the forward torpedo tubes. Look at me stuttering. I've patched the launch controls with a bit of code that will automate the hatch sequence on a 150-second timer, so that's why Sam has that little time to make his exit. That should be enough time to make it from the launch computer to the hatch, assuming they haven't anticipated an escape through the tubes and put a bunch of guards in the torpedo room. Wish me luck. Sofron. Sofron. I'm guessing that's how you would pronounce that name. I don't know any Russian at all. No Russian. Men. As you may have already deduced, tonight's operation will take us aboard a submarine. Due to the nature of the environment, you will not be permitted to use long arms or explosives. Colonel Budanov will come around and collect magazines from all of you. You will be issued shotguns and gas grenades in place of your rifles and fragmentation grenades. Oh, I see. You are not to replace the short rounds with slugs, as penetrating rounds could compromise the inner hull. You may continue to use short cartridge arms such as pistols and submachine guns, but be sure of your targets, as even the projectiles could cause inconvenient collateral damage to the vessels. Makes sense. Colonel Alexievich, the poor guy we killed in Kola. Actually, we didn't, we spared him. Colonel Budanov. It is my duty to report that Colonel Alexievich has still not arrived from our Kola base. Yeah, he's unconscious, leaving his helicopter now several hours overdue. The men awaiting him have critical duties to perform, and as time passes, their ability to achieve these objectives at all falls into doubt. Morale outside on the docks is dropping rapidly due to the cold, fatigue, and our delayed commander. I will do what I can and continue to stand my post until the arrival of Colonel Alexievich or until I receive further orders. Surgeon Mikhailov. Sort of makes me regret shooting them and killing them because, well, these are just people doing their jobs, you know. And death should really, especially an intentional death, should really not be an occupational hazard. Colonel Budanov, especially when it comes to, you know, to actual civilized societies called countries fighting each other. As promised, Mr. Mars has penetrated the security network and discovered the door code to the Vselka Armoury. The door, the code is, of course. Unfortunately, given the sad state of the bureaucracy of our former fatherland, the contents of the armoury have not been properly tracked. Be aware that former fatherland, huh? I thought only Germany used the term fatherland to refer to the country. Anyway. Have not been properly tracked. Please be aware that it may contain weapons that should not be fired aboard a submarine. I will send a further email to this effect to your men. I wonder if it's the room downstairs to the right. Anyway, let's just go ahead. At least we've got like this one carpeted area right here. So I think there's the submarine room is. Sorry, the armory is the one to our left, up ahead. Yeah. What was the door code again? 20387. Oh yeah, I've got wall mines. And wall mines. And frag grenades. And wall mines. And 572 ammo. And 556 ammo, and essentially everything that could cause a leak in the submarine. This is a nice little spot for a quick save. There's somebody patrolling up there. Oh yeah, I think it's actually one of the guards. I'll just use a sticky shocker for this guy, I suppose. And I think this is the last guard that we need to deal with. That's patrolling these catwalks. Or ramps, or whatever you call them. It's sort of strange how Fisher moves so much faster with his gun drawn. Is it dark in here? Dark enough to hide an unconscious person? Yes, it is. Because even if it isn't, I can just shoot this light out. cool. Whoops, I... Like, getting past this guy was also super tricky.
There's still blood frozen on some of the walls.
Are you taking the pills?
They help me sleep, but they don't stop the nightmares. To kill so many, so easily.
Forget about them. They were sailors and soldiers, men who chose to live by the gun. They should not have been surprised to likewise die.
Well, you do sort of make sense, but yeah, I would not exactly call them arguments. Any alarms? I'm guessing not. And this guy's in the shadows, so we can just shift this guy in the shadows as well, just as easily. I think he's already in the shadows, but just to be, you know, on the safer side. Yeah. And we need to open that hatch up so that we can drop down. You, sir, are not being spared. You're getting a bullet to the brain. And that is final. Come on. I'm just gonna quick save here again, and yeah, nothing to stop us here. So basically, that is the exit hatch, and some people are supposed to open it, except some people never do. And that was the glitch that I faced, so yeah. Or maybe I had to use the computer, who knows. Maybe I did. Maybe I had to use this computer here. Probably shouldn't have overridden the quick save in that case.
Who's out there? No! You can't hide forever! Come up wherever you are!
Oh! I got all four in one go. Or did I?
This guy's been...
I don't. I guess I was being too optimistic there. So I'm guessing that I need to use that computer to unlock that door. But yeah. I think I made the same mistake last time around as well. Because they don't really tell you anything about anything in this game. You just gotta sort of figure it out yourself. I almost thought that I had that guy as well, but turns out I didn't. I guess that should work. Use this computer. I don't think using it right now does it makes any difference. It just gives us a data stick. And we gotta use this laptop here.
Okay, we've got the signal. Can you trace it, Grim?
I might even be able to read it. Looks like a video signal. Yup, there.
Lambert.
Fantastic. Fisher, time for you to make yourself scarce.
So we are here. Where is this intruder?
Shh. He's got to be close by.
What exactly did you see?
A shadow that didn't have anything casting it. Just keep your eyes open.
Man down! He's dead!
And so are you. So let us try using this laptop right now. Yes, it does. And this guy has night vision goggles on.
Watch out, Fisher! You got incoming!
You sound surprised.
Now, I want to try something out here.
Take weapon backup!
Yeah, we can just sneak past these guys. Now, one thing that I want to try here is this. Yeah. I guess that's a free shot from here. Did we not just open this? Oh, this one. Of course. So basically what I wanted to try and do is obscure them, you know, obscure the vision of me using the smoke. Because we don't have any smoke grenades in this section, like in this game at least. Not that I can think of. We do have smoke in Chaos Theory, but I don't think we have any smoke in Splinter Cell per se. So I tried using the smoke grenades and I took off half my health in the process. Because I was trying to sneak past them using the wall. Because the last time I played that section, the door with the sniper in front of it, yeah, he saw me and he shot me regardless. So I tried using the smoke to mask myself and it seemed to have worked. It just, you know, brought them closer to the door. And I'm pretty sure that if I was playing the game how it's intended to be played, minus the first person mod, you know, with the third person perks, I probably could have snuck past them just as easily. But yeah, since well, it is what it is. I mean, it works. It does work. It obscures the vision. And I had to use thermal myself to see through the smoke quite a few times. And I honestly really like how they paid attention to all these tiny little details in this game, like, you know, bodies just losing heat as they die, and how light produces heat, how you can peek through thin surfaces, how lasers are hot, and how night vision gear, infrared gear, can actually see infrared light, which is basically lasers. So yeah, but anyway, as far as this mission is concerned, we have completed, you know, we essentially made sure that the nukes weren't there, and yeah, we just sort of decided to get out of there. So we went in, we confirmed our suspicions, not our suspicions, we confirmed the intent of the Russians and whether it would pose any sort of threat to us, and we made our way out, and that was that. That's all there is to it. And like they said, like one of the data sets said, these guys may look Russian, but they're not actually Russian. These were Nikolaj's mercenaries trying to carry on his legacy. And even Colonel Alexievich is not Russian. Russia is not involved in this at all. It was just more like a, you know, the remnants of the Georgian, you know, information crisis, if you would like to call it that. But anyway, that's it for this video, and that's it for Splinter Cell. I will be returning to playing Elder Scrolls Daggerfall after this, and wish me luck, because that game is something else, but I'll discuss that game when I'm playing that game. So until that time, take care, farewell, fellow things.